Hello guys, welcome to Chem presentation. So today we learn about Kumada coupling reaction. Kumada coupling reaction is one of the cross coupling reaction. So at first we have to know what is coupling. The coupling means the joining of two chemical species using any catalyst. This catalyst may be homogeneous catalyst or heterogeneous catalyst. Then we have to know what is cross coupling. The cross coupling means the joining of two dissimilar chemical species to afford a single product. There are various types of cross coupling reactions. As for example, Kumada coupling reaction, Negishi coupling, Suzuki coupling, Steele, Yama, Heck, Tandem Heck, and Sunakasa cross coupling reactions. But today we will learn about Kumada coupling reaction. What is Kumada coupling? The Kumada coupling reaction is the reaction of vinyl or aryl halide with Grignard reagent in presence of any nickel catalyst or palladium catalyst, generating unsaturated cross-coupled product. This is the general scheme of Kumada coupling reaction. Here we take one aryl halide or vinyl halide and it reacts with this type of Grignard reagent in presence of nickel or palladium catalyst to give this RR prime as the desired product, and here the byproduct is magnesium XX prime. This R may be aryl or vinyl group, and this R prime is aryl vinyl or alkyl group. Now we see the example of Kumada coupling reactions. Here at first we take one vinyl halide. It reacts with this type of Grignard reagent in presence of nickel catalyst to give this coupled product. Here the yield of the product is 80%. And as solvent, we use ether benzene and tetrahydrofuran as proportion 2:3:1. Now we take another aryl halide and it reacts with this type of Grignard reagent in presence of nickel catalyst to give this coupled product. So before going to the mechanism part, we must know about transmetallation. What is transmetallation? The transmetallation is the reaction is one of reaction where the exchange of ligand occurs with metal, and it occurs via the sigma bond metathesis pathway. Here we take one palladium X complex and another R prime M complex. The M may be any metal, and the reaction undergoes the sigma bond metathesis pathway through the formation of this four member ring. Here we see that the X ligand is attached with this palladium, but when transmetallation occurs, this X ligand exchanged with the metal M, and this R prime ligand which is attached to M is exchanged with the palladium, and we get the palladium R prime and MX. Now we see the mechanism of Kumada coupling reactions. For Kumada coupling reactions, nickel zero species is required. But nickel zero species is not commercially available. So we take at first the nickel 2 species, and nickel 2 species converts to nickel zero species in situ, that means in the reaction medium. So we see that we take at first nickel 2 species and it undergo the transmetallation reactions with this Grignard reagent. And this chlorine group which is attached to the nickel is exchanged with this magnesium group, and this R group which is attached to the magnesium is exchanged with this nickel. And again, when the second transmetallation occurs, this chlorine group which is attached to the nickel is exchanged with this magnesium, and another R group which is attached to this magnesium is exchanged with nickel to give this type of product, and it undergoes a reductive elimination reaction to give the nickel zero species, which is required for Kumada coupling reaction. And this nickel zero species undergo oxidative addition reactions with aryl halide or vinyl halide to give this type of nickel complex. And again, transmetallation occurs with Grignard reagent, and this X group which is attached to the nickel is exchanged with magnesium to give magnesium BrX, and this R group which is attached to the magnesium is exchanged with this nickel to give this product. And then the reductive elimination occurs to give the ARR, which is the desired product, and again nickel zero species is regenerated. So actually this is one catalytic process where again at the end of the reaction the nickel zero species is generated. Now we see the most commonly used ligand for Kumada coupling reactions. This is DPPP, diphenylphosphenopropane. This is diphenylphosphenobutane. This is beads, dimethylphosphenoferrocene, and diphenylphosphenoethane. Here we see that all of the ligands are bidentate ligand. The use of bidentate ligand is more favorable because the bidentate ligand enhances the catalytic activity. Here we see that if we use the bidentate ligand, then this eliminating group must remain in the cis position of the metal, which is the necessary condition of a reductive elimination reactions. So that's why we use the bidentate ligand. Now this is the order of the Kumada coupling reactions depending upon the ligand, and this order suggests that the cis configuration of two organic groups in the diorganonickel intermediate is the first requisite of the catalyst. Now we see the another example of Kumada coupling reaction. This is Gignard reagent and this is the aryl halide. We see that in this aryl halide two types of halide is present. One is fluorine and another is bromine. So one question arises in our mind that the rate of the Kumada coupling reaction depends upon the nature of halide. The rate of the Kumada coupling reaction increases if we change the halide from fluorine to chlorine to bromine to iodine. So here the bromine takes part in Kumada coupling reactions and this bromine is substituted to give the coupled product in presence of palladium catalyst. Now we see this is the regioselectivity. Regioselectivity is one of the important feature of Kumada coupling reactions. If we take one reactant with G geometry and it undergo the Kumada coupling reactions in presence of this Gignard reagent and nickel catalyst, we get the product having G geometry. Now here we see the reactant has E geometry and the product has also the E geometry. The retention of double bond is obtained, double bond geometry. So from these reactions we can conclude that the J reactant gives exclusively the G product and E reactant gives exclusively the E product. This is a recent advantage of Kumada coupling reactions. Previously we saw that in case of Kumada coupling reactions the aryl halide or vinyl halide takes part. So the CX bond is activated and here we take one ether compound and this is the CsP3O bond, and when this compound reacts with this type of Gignard reagent in presence of nickel catalyst we get this alkylated coupled product, and here the sp3 carbon and oxygen bond is activated, and this is also an reported Kumada coupling reactions, Kumada cross coupling reactions. So this is the recent advantage of Kumada coupling reactions. Thank you so much guys for watching this video.